Today's walk around is on one of Diamond C's most sought after equipment trailers, the LPX. That's low profile, extreme duty. Like all of the models on our website, you can customize the LPX there just to fit your needs. Whether it's gooseneck, bumper pull, different loading options, different GVWR combinations. So we're gonna go over this one in particular and see how it's outfitted. Obviously you can see right up front, gooseneck package selected. When you do the gooseneck package with Diamond C, you get the full width neck box. That's nothing but storage in there on the LPX. On some models that have a hydraulic pump or things like that, they're mounted in there. But in this one, you have the whole space for chains, boomers, you know, a block of wood, a quart of oil, all that kind of stuff. You can put in the box, locked out of the way. Dual spring-loaded drop leg jacks is part of it. On the LPX, on these gooseneck packages, they have the fold-down spare tire mount to where you're not trying to manhandle it on top. This one, they selected the rub rail and stake pocket option. The standard is 6 heavy-duty stake pockets for tying down, but on this one, with the rub rail, you can see you can put a strap or chain anywhere down the side of it. On this one, they selected the 36-inch wide deck step. That's for easy access on and off the bed. In the gooseneck package on the LPX, you get the chain tray winch mount as standard equipment. Now your winch can mount inside the tray and you remove this cover, or you have the receiver tube where you can put your winch on a removable mount. But all of this area is great for chain or strap storage. So moving on, the standard fender on these trailers is a 14-gauge tread plate fender. On this one, they selected the 3/16 super heavy duty fender. And when I say heavy duty, I know I don't weigh all that much, but normal 14-gauge would be already bowing with 180 pounds on it. So the great thing about these fenders, they protect your investment. If you're loading equipment and you bump into them, or you got hands running your equipment, not really watching what they're doing, they bump into something with these fenders, and whatever they hit is gonna be tore up, not the fender. So this one is a 20,000 pound GVWR package. That's a 210 K axle torsions, and it's got 215 17.5 rubber. When I say 20K GVWR, on this trailer is gonna give you about 16,000 pounds worth of payload capacity. That's huge. Because that's, I mean, any say of your heavier little excavators or skid steers, any of those is gonna be great for a construction company or heavy duty landscape, that kind of thing. When you choose the 20K GVWR package, it comes with an engineered I-beam. So much like the F-Max series, where we really have control over the height and weight of the beam and how strong they are, the same technology is in this LPX. It's an engineered beam from one end to the other. We're not taking just a standard old I-beam and hacking it up to try and make it into a trailer. We're specifically building the I-beam for the weight, the height, and the strength that it needs to be to get the job done with this one. Lastly, we come to loading options. On the LPX, there's a couple of different ones. You can get a straight deck with sliding ramps. You can get a 2-foot dove with stand-up ramps, or as seen here is the max ramps. Now, the max ramps are really cool because, as you can see, they can either be stood in the upright position or the down position for travel. If they're in the down position, like this trailer's 24 feet, so it's 24 from the back of the neck to right here. So you've got this whole area to use as working space. But say you load a tractor with a cutter or a mower on the back of it, and it sticks off into this space, well, you can just stand the ramp straight up, just like seen here. So they can either be stood up or laid down. The other cool thing is when they're both down, you have almost a full width loading surface. So whether it's antique tractors or skid steers or gosh, rollers, all kinds of stuff, you've got a nice wide, stable, safe loading surface to go up and down. The last thing that I would point out, the hinge mechanism on these max ramps, the hinge and spring mechanism, is built just like our big max ramps on the F-Max series, which it has the spring on the outside of the bumper and one on the inside and a knee on the inside. And all of that means is it makes it to where when you load your equipment, it pushes the force into the knee of the ramp and it doesn't let it flip up on you like you've seen, or if you've ever have experience loading equipment, you get all the weight on the dovetail and it tries to make the ramp flip up. Instead, this one drives the pressure into the knee of the ramp in the ground, spurring it into the ground. That way you don't have that experience. That's a wrap for the walk around on this LPX. Jump on DiamondC.com to find out what else makes this one of DiamondC's most sought after equipment trailers, or build one to fit your needs there. Comment down below, what would you use this particular LPX for? Make sure to like us on Facebook, follow us on Instagram, subscribe to our YouTube channel for all of our latest videos, and we'll see you on the road.